The sound clip that we recorded is running under a number of different panels, so the first thing I'll do is to cut up the sound into clips. I can hear the sound as I go through it, and that's because I've turned on scrubbing. So make sure that this is checked to say sound scrubbing, and then you will be able to hear it, which makes it easier for you to edit your animatic. So I'm going to split the silence at the beginning, and I'm going to split the whistle, and I'll split this line because there are three different panels that I want to put it under. So I'll position my playhead here. I'm going to right click on that soundtrack and say split clip at current frame. I'm going to do that again after the line. Split clip at current frame. Here's the whistle next. So let me split it after the whistle. And I could take out some of the silence here. I'm going to right click and split. I will delete that gap. I will delete that gap. And at the end, I will split it here also. And then get rid of the excess. Now right now, if I play this, you'll see that the audio does not sync up with the images. So I'll play it and you can see this.
Here, Spot. Come on, boy, where are you hiding?
Well, actually, it almost does. So here's, though, how you can position things. In a sense, this is how you edit the animatic. I want the sound to start at the very beginning. I like the timing of the sound. That's what I'm going to base everything around. So now, this is the line, here, Spot. And this is the line here spot in the timeline. So I just want to match the drawing to the recording. And now this panel is going to sound like this.
Here spot.
The next panel is whistling, but here's my whistle track. So I will take this and shorten the duration for it to match. And now this panel, I will also play this one. Okay. And after that is this line.
Come on, boy, where ya? Come on, boy, where ya?
Okay, so what's making this tricky is that this sound clip is longer than the duration of the panel. So I need to extend the duration of this panel to match the duration of the sound clip.
Come on, boy, where ya hiding? Come on, boy, where ya hiding?
All right, that works out great. So I'll come back to the very beginning, go to the first frame, and now I will play this from the beginning.
Here, Spot. Come on, boy, where are you hiding?
All right, so somehow that whistle got clipped a little bit. There it is. So the sound itself, if I squeeze it in too much, will get clipped. So there's the whistle in its entirety. So I need to move this panel to the end of the whistle, move this panel in without overlapping, and now I should be back in business. I'm going to press the A key to get back to the very beginning, and I'm going to play it one more time from the top.
Here, Spot. Come on, boy, where are you hiding?
All right, so you can see that is the way that we're going to edit our animatic. We're just going to repeat the process all the way through. And if you're importing audio tracks, it works the same way. You'll just need to right-click on the soundtrack and go to Import Sound Clips, and then click on this folder, and you can navigate to any place on your computer where you may be storing an audio file. You can import a WAV file, an AIFF, an AIF, or an MP3. I'm going to record the rest of the script now so that I can go in and put all that in for a complete animatic with sound.